Always have to work multiple squads on the same base station. What about the squads working out of St. Francis and our general in the same problem?
I'm afraid that's one of the technical problems we'll just have to try and work around. For the time being, there just aren't enough hospitals equipped to supervise the rescue units. Until we get those working out a system of priorities.
You mean like they're giving support thoughts on your bit?
Well, that's about it. You're going to have to depend on our judgment here at Rampart based on the information you give us. Though some of you have feelings to the contrary. At the moment, there's no better way to operate.
Then, you make a decision between one life and another.
Don't back me into a corner, Johnny. While you're dependent on us prescribing treatment, we're also dependent on you. You're our eyes, remember that.
Then what do we do if we have this umbrella situation on the same frequency? Two squads like 51 has today.
We're working both ends just to get in.
And a third squad has to get in, that?
If the radio's jammed, they can phone on the landline. We can handle EKGs over the phone.
What happens if there's enough phones in victim's location?
We just have to tell the other squads to stand by while you send us 10 to 15 seconds of strip over the biophone. Based on that, it's up to us to make the decision who gets first crack at.
So if you're working in a squad, what do the rest of us do?
You could call in on your fire department frequency to the dispatcher. Have him phoned in over the landline. He can relay back and forth between here and the squad.
But you can't send an EKG that way.
In that case, no. You'd have to rely on your evaluation of the victim's condition and what you're getting on your cardiac score.
It really isn't a foolproof system, is it?
No, it isn't. It's a lot better system than existed before your rescue squads were authorized to operate as paramedics.
We have deal with problems like that, Jake.
That's what I mean. Trained, you're better than that.
Dr. Early, here's my
pretty dream. Look right here.